within specialty chemical makers seem to be a rather rare breed right now. Four of them, or actually more than four of them, are investing in adding capacity at a time when the most promoters are dragging their feet on new investments in India Inc. Yash Upadhyay is here to tell us why. It's not just four, right? Yash, a clutch of these specialty chemical companies are expanding capacity. Why is it that they are doing?
So we've seen that most of these companies have seen a strong growth over the last 5 years, and it seems that they are preparing for the next leg of growth going forward. And while we are just using the example of these four companies, these are in a way representations of the sectors to which these specialty company chemical companies cater to. So starting first with Aarti Industries, and they have almost a capex target of closer to around 1000 to 1200 crore rupees, followed by SRF, which could overshoot their mark of 800 crores for FY20, along with Deepak Nitrite and Fine Organics, who will be combined looking to invest higher than 600 crores in this year. Where will this money be going in? For Aarti Industries, they are looking to expand their specialty chemical complex, as well as setting up of a new acid reconcentration plant, along with several other projects that they already have in the store. For SRF, a large chunk of their expansion is mostly in the packaging and films business. So they're coming up with an integrated PTFE plant as well as a new BOPP plant in Thailand. But in their recent con call post, their Q3 numbers, they said that they are increasing their capex in the specialty chemical side as well. Deepak Nitrite, a large chunk of it is going towards expansion as well as the debottlenecking projects. And Fine Organics, they are coming up with two new 10,000 million tons per annum facilities. One would be exclusive for the food additives business, and the other one is in joint venture with their partner Adcotex. Now, why are we seeing these companies expand their capacities? And there are three main reasons over here. First, well, the clampdown in China that has seen most of the business coming through to the Indian companies. So over the last few years, we've seen that the Chinese authorities have been getting stricter and stricter with respect to their environmental norms. And as a result of this, there's a Crystal report that says that nearly 50 to 55 companies have had to shut down or relocate their plants. And as a result of this and the increased compliance costs, most of the foreign or the international clients, they have had to take a new route, and the Indian companies have able to come in and fill that gap. Not just that, there has been growing demand in India itself. There is a JM Financial note that says that over FY18 to FY25, the demand for specialty chemicals is seen growing at a compounded annual growth rate of 10 to 15%, and large chunk of that is seen coming in from the agrochemical, pharma, as well as the home care products. One of the examples of the strong domestic demand is take the example of Deepak Nitrite. So they have recently come up with their Deepak Phenolics plant, which was set up, which was commissioned in November. And before this plant came up, only 20% of the phenol demand in India was met domestically, while 80% had to be imported. With this plant coming in, it has not only been able to generate cater to the strong demand in the domestic market, but it has also acted as an import substitution, because now it is able to meet most of the domestic requirement for phenol, and has also saved in terms of forex for the government. Next up is why are we seeing these companies expand their capacity? We've established that there is strong demand both in the international market as well as the domestic market, but most of these companies in their latest conference call have mentioned that they are operating at near optimum level. Take for example Aarti Industries, which is the largest chlorobenzene player, and they said in their con call that their facilities are operating at 90% plus capacity utilization levels. Similar is the case when it comes to Fine Organics as well as Deepak Nitrite. So most of these companies, they are already operating at full capacity. And lastly, one sector which has largely benefited from the government incentive is this one, because the thrust on Make in India, as well as the imposition of levies and duties on chemical companies abroad, which had been dumping their chemicals in the Indian markets, that has managed to safeguard this industry and keep it on the track for growth going forward. I mentioned about the strong growth over the last 5 years, and take a look at their sales, EBITDA and net profit growth over the last 5 year period. And on a compounded annual basis, we've seen these companies report strong growth. Their top line has been in mid to high teens. Their EBITDA has been in 20% plus range, and their net profit, in fact, has been higher than that. It has been 30% plus in the last 5 year period. Return ratios too have been extremely healthy. Both the ROE and the ROCEs have been upwards of 20%. One name that really stands out over here is that of Fine Organics. Both in terms of the return ratios as well as the financials, it has been a rank outperformer. It is one of the largest producers producers globally as well of oleo-based chemical additives, and it has been doing extremely well. And while these companies on a like-to-like basis are not comparable, and we are not just, you know, comparing these four companies within themselves, but as a sub-segment within the whole specialty chemical space, what one thing is common across all of these is that they have given extremely good returns to investors. And this is over the one-year period that we've seen all of these companies gain more than 50 to 60%. Aarti Industries did come off a little bit after their Q1 earnings, when they said that they would not be able to meet the upper end of their guidance, but still it is sitting at gains of closer to around 30%, which is substantially higher than what we've seen most of the other sectors do.
Okay, well, let's watch out. Usually capex and plans announced after high capacity utilization in a spate of high demand means that the return and the turnover of the plant, or the return on the investment done on a plant, is much faster, and that is something that markets typically like. So maybe the markets would like this as well. Yash, thanks so much for putting that into perspective.